What comes to mind when you think of the first human-made object in space? Probably the venerable Sputnik 1, launched by the Soviets in October of 1957, right? Oh, that's a nice try. Okay, so maybe Explorer 1, launched by the US in 1958. Come on, you're way, way off. Yeah, it was the Nazis. Actually, it really was. According to the generally accepted definition of where space begins, known as the Kármán line, the magic number is 100 kilometers above the Earth's surface. Named after Hungarian engineer and physicist Theodor von Kármán, it's reasoned that the defining line between Earth and space comes at a point where the planet's atmosphere is too thin to allow typical aircraft to generate aerodynamic lift for flight. Beyond that, they become spacecraft, and the discussion turns into staying aloft through orbital velocity rather than lift. And that happens at around 91 kilometers straight up. Kármán suggested adopting a nice round number to make it memorable, so 100 kilometers it is. The 9-kilometer difference doesn't really matter anyway, because the transition between atmosphere and space is not any kind of razor-sharp line that causes planes to drop from the sky over a matter of a few feet. It was the middle of World War II, and the Nazi war effort was in full effect. What was originally called the A-series of rockets was first imagined by then-graduate student Wernher von Braun, and the German military took notice. The plans were complete by 1941, and the first test flight happened in 1942. But Hitler was initially unimpressed. He considered von Braun's rocket to be nothing more than an artillery shell with a longer range, and much, much higher price tag. Each V-2 launch cost the equivalent of $250,000 in 2017. Plus, plans had the rockets being built by slave labor in concentration camps, which tended to produce very low-quality results. By the end of 1942, the project had been renamed V-2, and Hitler had changed his mind. The V-2 became a common weapon against Allied countries in 1943 and 1944. Of the more than 5,000 produced, roughly 3,000 were launched into Belgium and the UK alone. The accuracy was not great, and the British Security Service had launched Operation Doublecross to feed the Nazis inaccurate information about damage from V-2 strikes, which caused the Nazis to adjust V-2 targeting even further away from London and other prized targets. Although technically impressive for the era, the V-2 was not the mighty hammer of the gods that von Braun and the Nazis hoped. Among the dozens of routine V-2 test flights was MW-18014 on June 20, 1944. MW-18014 reached an altitude of 176 kilometers before falling back to Earth in a smoking pile of junk a few minutes later. It was a suborbital flight, which means that Sputnik 1 is still the first human craft to ever orbit the planet. But the Nazis and MW-18014 beat the Soviets and everyone else into space by 13 years. Since then, the accomplishment has been brushed aside somewhat to avoid crediting the Nazis with anything. Even NASA itself considers the 1949 flight of the Bumper 5 craft to be the first human object into space, reaching an altitude of 393 kilometers. NASA's view might hinge on a higher definition of the space boundary, or it might just be a justifiable attempt to keep the Nazis off any historical podiums. I'm curious, what do you think about this? Let me know in the comments. MW-18014 has never reached the same level of fame as Sputnik 1 or Apollo 11. Even the Nazis themselves didn't make a big deal out of it. The machine's remnants were likely just simply melted down to make more rockets for the war effort. Or some innocent farmer found the pieces in a crater on his land and used it to patch up his barn. There's no record of anything beyond the flight itself, but by most measurements, it was the first object made by humans that flew into space. If you think this stuff is interesting, please pass it around. This channel really does need shares to grow, and every little mention on social media helps. If you win a bet with what you saw here, at least tell the poor sucker where you heard it as you're stuffing his sweet, sweet cash into your pocket. And as always, like and subscribe for more from the WildAC channel. Thanks for watching.